Previously on The Mole.
You may have noticed that one of the players in your group, Steven, is missing. Your test is to try to find him.
Steve! That's gotta be him!
You know what's gonna blow this for us? It's gonna be Jennifer.
Jennifer!
It's over.
Thanks, Henry.
Somebody there is not telling the truth.
Look at me! I ran my butt off!
You don't just dump 50 grand, 50 grand, 50 grand.
I think we should just pull the trigger.
I can't hear you!
Run, 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 run.
If a red thumbprint appears, you are the mole's second victim. Afi? Play a great game.
Thank you.
10 strangers playing for up to $1 million. Among them, a saboteur, a traitor, the mole. The winner, the one who answers the question, who is the mole? Afi is gone. And then there were eight. Eight players getting to know each other. Conflicts arise. Personalities clash. Is it honest emotion, or is it the work of the mole?
Afi is gone. It's a relief that I'm not gone.
I would have really liked a few other people to go. I would have liked to see Henry go.
I'm still feeling really good about the game, really confident.
Sometimes I think I'm gonna wake up and it's all gonna be a dream, but it isn't.
What do I know? I'm just a simpleton here, trying to get through, one round at a time.
With $135,000 in the pot, the players leave France. Their next destination, Spain, renowned for its bullfights and beautiful beaches. The players' confidence in each other is in question because they failed two of their last three tests. For the 10th day, tension is growing between the players, and Charlie is getting tired and, well, cranky.
Anybody go for a little fresh air in this vehicle?
Yeah, absolutely. You want a little bit of AC?
Yeah, there, just, I can't have it blowing on me too much.
Just crack a window and get some fresh air in.
You got it cracked here as much as I want.
I wish you'd break up the vans according to passengers who like it hot and stuffy and those who like it airy.
Obviously, we're at diverse ends of the air spectrum.
The only time I remember was the time you wanted more air conditioning. You had two sweaters on. I said, why don't you just take the sweater off if you're hot?
How about the time 30 seconds ago when I asked her to crack a window and you said, I'm cracking it as much as I will? So you're the window police. You're in charge of the windows. Is that the idea?
Well, you got up on the wrong side of the bed today.
I will vouch for that because it was a little snappy with me this morning, too.
The players arrive at a lavish five-star hotel in Santipetri, where a relaxing meal awaits them. While they dine, they enter into a philosophical discussion of trust and friendship in a game of deceit.
If you make a close friendship with someone and it's based on lies, isn't that kind of a difficult thing?
Part of it isn't lies. I may lie to them because that's a parameter of the game which I find acceptable because everyone has come to that table with that expectation.
It's going to evolve into everybody becoming battling with each other and you'll lose friendships that have been acquired. That's what I'm afraid will happen.
I mean, I applaud anybody that outwits me, you know, if they're the mole and I can't figure it out. You did your job. You did your job, Steve.
The next morning, before our players get too comfortable, they find they're whisked away in a van, secreted to a country location. The players are dropped off by the side of a dirt road and left to find the rest of the way on foot. They have no idea what awaits them.
It's a hike, guys.
No Anderson in sight. Looks like a bull ring down there.
All right.
Beautiful day for bullfight, don't you think? As you may know, bullfighting is a national obsession here in Spain. We thought it's something you all should take part in. So far, you have $135,000 in the pot. Today's test could be worth up to $75,000, depending on how well you do. For this test, each of you must enter the ring. You have to face two charges from the bull. Each charge, the bull has to touch your cape as it goes by you to pass the test.
This is a vicious bull.
We don't get this guy. This guy looks pretty vicious.
You can earn an additional $25,000 for the group if five of you successfully complete what's called a tienta. A tienta is a move to check the bull's aggression. It's a way of bringing the bull onto the ground. All right, who's going first?
I'm first.
Henry. Who's going first? Henry, you're right first?
Henry's first up.
All right, let's get started.
Hey, good luck, Henry.
That's what I'm talking about. Team, team! Players, players, let's make it happen, baby!
Way to go, Henry!
Is that one? Andre, Andre, Iba! Come on with your bad self!
He's asking for an ass whooping out there.
Got him.
That's two! That's two!
Get his tail! Get his tail!
That's what I'm talking about, baby!
Henry scored the first tienta, as the bull's rear need only touch the ground. Now it's Charlie's turn to face the bull, only he's not quite as enthusiastic as Henry was.
How do you feel about this, Charlie?
I feel confident.
Yeah?
That's what I'm saying. In my heart. I'm ready.
Ready as love, baby.
Charlie!
Yeah! Yeah.
Charlie, just pretend it's me. Just pretend it's me.
Okay, Bull, I'm ready.
Charlie, get ready, Charlie!
I don't like Kate. She's a
what
she was probably born.
Go for the tienta.
Tienta!
You got it, Charles. Are you all right?
think I got the Tienta. I tried to, you know, like smother him with the cape, and so I could grab his tail.
Let's get you ready.
Charlie comes out, and his arms are dripping blood, and it's like, oh, I'm not really sure I want to do this.
What is the next?
This out, please. Run.
Good luck.
Bueno, otro.
So, who's next?
I am.
That's why I want to go last. I make sure everybody goes.
Oh, is that why you want to go last?
I'm going to push you.
That's not going to change my opinion that you might be the mole, you know.
Right. Talk to it, Kate. Talk to it.
I'm speechless.
Nice job, Kate!
Did that count?
Yeah, that counts.
Yes! I have now got a bruise on my rear. All right.
Jennifer's in the ring.
Hey, Tora! Holy shimmy! You didn't have to come so quick. Oh my God. Whoa, get her.
Intense.
Jennifer performed the second Tienta, raising the pot an additional $5,000, but only if all eight of them face the bull. If one of them refuses, her work was in vain.
You did it.
Wait, who's next?
Excellent. Me.
All right,
go for it, Wendy.
Excellent.
There we go.
Let's go, Wendy.
Come on, Wendy, you can do it.
Yeah, baby.
Mr. Bullfighter, can you come closer to me?
That's one! Woo!
Okay, you got him. You got him. All right, way to go. Good girl.
Nicely done!
Bullfight!
Does that one count?
Yes, that counts. Good job. All right, who's left?
Steve.
All right.
Big Steve, he's going for the Tienta.
Your turn. This way.
So this is it, Steve.
Seven of the players have successfully faced the bull. But can they count on Steven to follow through?
I got faith in Steve.
I got faith in that brother too, so let's make it happen.
One more pass now.
One more pass. Steve, you got the Tienta. You just need one more pass to the ball.
No sweat. Hey! Two Tientas?
No, you don't need it. Get out of there. Get out of the way.
Okay, hang on.
Yes! Woo! You won!
Steven earned the group's third Tienta.
There's no style and no grace, but I could have had two of them.
All right, you guys did an excellent job because you all faced the bull successfully. You made $50,000. Because you had three Tientas, you earned an extra $15,000. So the group pot is now $200,000.
Yeah.
And you are going to be camping around the bull ring tonight. And congratulations. Great day.
All right.
After several nights of five-star hotels, tonight the players will rough it, camping out under the stars.
Well, you know what the guys don't
As darkness falls over the campsite and everyone settles into their new surroundings, the players are treated to a fiesta of local music and food. Wendy, Charlie, and Jennifer let their hair down with some drinking and dancing.
We have music for the first time in so long. Music!
Later in the evening, as everyone gathers around the campfire, Charlie's feelings about Kate come to the surface.
Her voice. You like me better when I was woodwork.
No, I don't like Kate. She's a
what
she's
is she?
She was probably born.
What did she ever do to you, Charlie?
You're out. She doesn't have to do anything.
Why?
She just has to be herself, and she's a.
You seem to be a by saying that.
Every time they'll tell you that we're all going here now, right? And you know, so she'll turn to me and say, "We're all going here." I said, "I already know we're all going there." She repeats everything. But that bugs me because I know I'm going there. I will do something and she'll say, "That's not in the rules." And I heard the rules the same as you did.
Hey, Charlie.
I don't need to reiterate.
You ever hung out around a campfire?
No.
I'd rather be someplace else, but we're here. I'll do it, whatever we have to do.
Hey, tell them the door hit your ass on the way out, all right?
Charlie at dinner got a little drunk and, he said a couple of things to Kate. You know, it was just downright mean, and I kind of feel like, hey, man, cut it out, you know?
I've been able to just ignore it, and that's my tactic, because then, you know, it will end.
Now, in each envelope, there are two assignments. I just want to apologize in advance, because this next test can get a little bit unpleasant.
It's the dawn of a new day. Last night's outbreak of emotion left everybody on edge. But today, they'll need to set that aside if they want to succeed. After fighting a bull and braving the open night air, the players are exhausted. But the game goes on. Today's test will challenge their ingenuity as well as their luck.
I'm sorry you all didn't have a better night's sleep. I need three volunteers. First, I need someone who is fearless. All right, Henry? Fearless. I need someone who has a winning smile.
Oh, nobody else wants a smile, I'll smile.
Charlie, all right. And I need one more person, someone whom you all trust with your personal possessions.
Kate's looking right at me. Oh, great. I'm going to do all your laundry. I can just tell.
Well, actually, now that you mention it, I would like everyone else to get their dirty laundry because these three do have a lot of work ahead of them.
Wait, did we really decide on me?
Yeah.
I'm afraid so.
Yeah, I trust you.
Yeah. You know what? Don't. That's all I'm saying. Don't trust me.
All right, so the three people who are doing laundry, I want you to come follow me.
So we are doing laundry.
Oh, you're doing laundry. And everyone else, I'll meet you at the church.
Henry, Jennifer, and Charlie prepare to do the laundry, though Jennifer's still not sure how she got herself roped into this.
It wasn't so much the laundry part, but out of all the people that I'd have to spend the day with.
What Henry, Charlie, and Jennifer don't know is that there are no laundromats in this quaint little town. We brought them to where laundry used to be done, the old wash basin.
Oh, God! I told you it was not going to be traditional laundry. This is so messed up.
Today's test is relatively simple. To pass the test, you have to wash, dry, and fold all the group's laundry. If you do this before 8 p.m., you'll pass the test. Pass the test, you earn $10,000 for the group pot. This is the town wash basin. You can do one load of laundry here. You're going to have to find other locations to do the rest of the laundry. So we're going to give you one Spanish-English dictionary. Use it. I suggest you look up the words laundry and help.
They're told they must wash, dry, and fold only one load of laundry per location. With eight bags to wash, they'll just have to be creative.
There was a huge language barrier. We were given this Spanish-English dictionary and basically just shoved on the side of the road, and they said bye-bye.
Laundry, lavandera. Lavandera. Ropa sucia.
See, ropas.
Ropa sucia. Ropas.
Across town at the top of the hill is the Church of Medina Sidonia, where the other players will try their luck at a game of dice.
It's time for your next test, and I just want to apologize in advance because this next test can get a little bit unpleasant.
Test depends on luck. Each player picks an envelope that contains a choice of two assignments. One is simple, one's unpleasant.
You'll roll this die. Now you roll a 1, 2, or 3, you get to choose the relatively simple assignment. You roll a 4, 5, or 6, you get the unpleasant one. 3 out of 5 of you have to successfully complete your assignments in order to pass this test. Pass the test, the group earns $40,000 for the pot. All right, who wants to go first? All right.
Steven?
Everyone else, go upstairs, stay here.
Upstairs, the group is sequestered, so they won't know Steven's assignment or his roll of the die.
Pick your envelope. Okay.
Open it.
Open it, and see what it says.
One, two, or three, paint a nude portrait, or 4, 5, or 6, pose nude.
How do you feel?
I'm going for 1, 2, or 3.
Yeah?
I don't know about the posing nude.
All right, let's begin the task.
Ready?
Yeah.
Son of a...
So that's a 5. Probably not what you were hoping for. As the rules state, roll 4, 5, or 6, you pose nude. So, what's it gonna be?
All right.
What about you?
Are you in Rio?
With only one load washed, the laundry team struggles to communicate with the townspeople.
Can we use your laundry?
¿A ti que la ropa tendría que va a hacer?
No, a mano.
Uh-huh.
No.
Oh.
Para otra mano, no.
Para lavar la ropa.
¿Tú quieres una lavadora o lavama?
I only have washing machine.
Oh, perfecto!
I can't imagine in the United States somebody coming up to my neighbor or myself and speaking in a foreign language and asking to use my wash machine for a load of wash. I would, you know, call 911 and say, I have a lunatic here, send this, and somebody with a straitjacket. But it worked.
Muchas gracias, amiga.
While Jennifer, Henry, and Charlie do the laundry, a local artist awaits Stephen's arrival.
What's the pose gonna be here? Pose?
Four, five, or six, shave your head.
While Steven gets ready to expose his soul to the world, the others are told what his two possible assignments were.
I don't know if he would be painted nude. We just had a big discussion about.
I told him at Chippendale, and he said, don't even go there.
Yeah.
All right, okay. Come on, oh, quick.
4 envelopes. You're free to pick whichever you'd like.
There, from the left. Want me to open it? 1, 2, or 3, cast one leg. 4, 5, or 6, cast both legs. For how long?
Till tomorrow.
They're both tomorrow. Unpleasant.
Mm-hmm. It's all relative.
Okay, what else could they do?
I just wanted...
So it's like embarrassment. It's public humiliation
exactly,
that you're after, really?
Exactly. All I wanted to do was laundry.
As Steven and Jim decide what sacrifices they're willing to make for the team, our launderers prove that even a dirty task can be done with style.
Yeah. We eventually ended up running into this guy named Jose, who was like the town mayor or something, because dude went through the town and the doors were open and the washing machines came out.
You are sent from heaven.
Okay, we'll be back.
I don't want to do this.
No.
Sorry. Can't do it.
So I was a little uncomfortable with that. Maybe if I was had Henry's body or something, sure.
Remind you of the rules. Roll 4, 5, or 6, you agree to put a cast on both legs. All right.
Oh, my God. When do I have to choose?
Make your decision. Think about it. Have you ever worn a cast?
Never in my life. All right, I'll do it.
If you rolled a 4, 5, or 6, he would have a cast put on both his legs.
Forever?
Till tomorrow.
That was easy.
You don't think that'd be any big deal? Having
no, I mean, I would choose it, but I'd rather do that than be naked in front of the whole country.
Yes, exactly. I mean, it sounds way better than the first one you came up here
Let's
with.
Let's figure we've got one win.
Who wants to go next? Okay. Yes. All right.
Good luck. Good luck.
Thanks, guys.
You'll do great.
After you.
This is exactly what we were just saying upstairs. 1, 2, or 3, dye your hair. What color?
Green.
4, 5, or 6, shave your head. Green, permanently green?
No, not permanently green. Just till tomorrow. Which one are you hoping for?
What do you think? Oh, my God. I'm not going to do it. There's no way I'm shaving my head. I'm sorry. Absolutely no way. I'm getting married in, like, 4 months.
So absolutely, bottom line, you will not do that.
I can't. I'm not going to shave my head.
Now that Catherine and Steven have refused their assignments, Wendy, Jim, and Kate must complete theirs in order to pass the test.
What does it say?
1, 2, or 3, wear a ball and chain. 4, 5, or 6, wear a stockade.
The choice is
yours.
Let
the games begin. Okay.
In order to pass the test, you have to wear the stockade until tomorrow. You'll do it?
I'll do it.
Yeah?
I'll do it.
Hello. Do you know why I'm here?
No, not yet.
I just kind of want to check it out, look at it. I don't know for sure if I'm going to do this. Oh, it looks so very comfortable. I'm just trying it on, right?
Yeah,
you can take it off. Okay. I don't quite have to lock it up yet. I'm not quite sure about this. Probably I'm not going to do this. I'm not gonna be doing any jogging. Hey, thanks. Cute. Funny.
Hello, anyone?
For the love of God, someone help me. This is not fun.
I saw one. Hold on. Can I tell you what happened? When we went to pick them up.
Just when they thought they were done, Jennifer spots a pair of unwashed socks in the bottom of Charlie's bag. According to the rules, they'll have to return to the house where the rest of Charlie's laundry was done and wash and dry the last pair of socks, all before 8 o'clock.
A pair of socks mysteriously is dirty in somebody's bag and left there, and I found it. Let's go.
Back at the church, Kate, the fifth and final player, awaits her fate.
I've got a proposal to make to you. I'm going to give you the chance to take all four assignments that the other players were offered.
Now, Kate, you don't know how the other players have done, but if they've succeeded and you do all four of your assignments, you'll double the pot to $80,000. If they haven't succeeded, you can be the hero today. Do all four of your assignments, and you'll single-handedly earn $40,000 for the pot.
Not only that, you'll earn an exemption from the next execution. You won't have to take the quiz. There's no way you can be executed. Feeling lucky?
No. Still try it.
One, two, or three, you paint a nude. Four, five, or six, you get painted in the nude. Painted in the nude. You wear a cast on both legs. You dye your hair. The old ball and chain.
Wash them.
All right, that's it. Everything's been washed.
Let's go dry
Thanks
out.
Again. Hang them up. Thank you.
That's it.
Gracias.
Mi amigos y amigas, gracias.
I just think Henry is really a proud guy, but he totally came through as far as the laundry test goes. Without Henry, we certainly would have been without a prayer.
Yeah, I was very amazed that we did that job. I was also very chagrined that we only got $10,000 for doing it. That was an all-day job, but I don't set those prices.
And that was totally a very nice opportunity.
I almost stopped my heart, though, man. Steve was like, you okay in there, man? I was like,
hey, what's up? Talk to us. Where's the rest of it? Where's your video?
We want $10,000.
You're kidding.
We want $10,000. Look at your clothes.
Nice.
If I rolled a 4, 5, or 6, I would have to be the nude.
So you didn't want to be painted nude?
Which means you lost. If you were painted nude, you would.
How much money?
$40,000.
$40,000, and we were about 10. And you wouldn't be painted nude?
Steve, that's not a big deal. You know, just have whoever's painting the portrait enhance it a little bit.
How are you being, my man? How are you doing?
All right.
Good, man.
All right, we already found out he failed. Please tell me that you succeeded. Well, Jim evidently didn't have a problem.
I did not succeed. Oh. I had to put 2 casts on my legs.
I would have rather done either of those than what we had to do running around doing your laundry today.
We did to get your clothes clean, and you couldn't wear 2 casts?
Struggling up and down the hill.
And you couldn't pose nude?
We have Catherine now.
Tell me you won.
Yes.
Tell me you won.
I have no idea.
What did you do?
Did you do it?
What did you roll?
What'd you roll?
You didn't do it. You didn't do it.
Oh, you did.
What did you have to do? What did you have to do?
You refused to put 2 casts? You big chicken?
What did you refuse to do?
Shave my head.
I would have done that too!
I've been like this all day long.
Oh my God.
My neck is your teammates didn't do their so you guys
I see that. I see that. You guys suck. So, oh my God. You guys, seriously, I've been in this all day long. Here, we gotta get something to hold it up.
I tell me about it.
We get a key for this poor girl.
This is sad. Sitting in the middle of a small Spanish town in a stockade is very, very sad.
All I know is I have a bruised collarbone.
This test had a twist to it that you all didn't know about. We made Kate an offer that, depending on her confidence in you, she could do all 4 assignments, and you did the assignments as well, she would double your money.
Oh my God.
If you did not do the assignments, and she did all 4 assignments, she would earn $40,000 for the group pot. So she would make up for what all of you did not do.
Will Kate succeed where they all have failed? $40,000 is at stake.
So far, you've all been playing the game very well. Tonight, you face your 3rd execution.
So where the heck is Baldy?
As the night wears on, we anxiously await Kate's arrival. Will she do all 4 assignments and earn $40,000 for the pot?
I think she might.
I think she might.
There's no way she would have gotten
that. I bet she does.
does.
I bet she does.
I'll bet you she does.
She's not going to shave her head.
So whatever
No, she said she'd shave her head.
She did?
Yeah, Wendy and I were like, people not doing it.
She would have changed it.
She even said that she would have shaved her head.
I definitely think she would do it.
She probably would have dyed her hair.
She even said
earlier when we heard Steve saying that she wouldn't have posed naked.
She has no idea what it did to her.
Hey! Kyrie, watch me! Yay! Tell me you did everything! She dyed her hair!
Like to bend the hero. And all of a sudden, here comes Kate up the street. Kate! And everybody's running to Kate. There's me. Okay, I've worn this all day long, and where's my loyalty now? It would have been kind of fun to be like the hero for a day.
There's also something else that Kate earned for herself tonight. Why don't you tell him?
I had a little extra incentive. If I completed all four, I also got exemption from the next execution.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, that's really nice. Oh, so you deserve it.
Oh, that is nice.
Okay, then I have to carry my own chain. Okay.
Oh, I brought some.
What's going on?
Yeah. Anderson speaks.
Good news, it is now tomorrow. You survived all day with your ball and chain.
Came a time when I was probably finding Kate a little bit annoying, and after yesterday with her going out and getting $40,000 for the group and everything else like that, I have changed, so that's over.
We're talking asthma, sore legs, joints, you name it, Kate's got it. But since she received a pass for this next quiz, she hasn't complained one iota about anything. So Kate, bravo on being a hypochondriac.
Thanks to Kate, $40,000 will be added to the pot. There's little time for celebration or blame. Another execution awaits. Their fate will be decided by the question, who is the mole?
Wendy seems to be the least copious of all the note-taking. She's just like, you know, sit back in the background, doesn't really have much to say. Every once in a while, sort of proves that she's, you know, that she's part of the players. But I don't see how she can make it through these executions, you know, with her technique.
Kate's confused me because I thought Kate was probably the mole, and then this last thing made me less maybe skeptical of her.
Kate is still a mole. People say, well, she's now got an exemption and she did all that. She got $40,000 individually, and I give her a heck of a lot of credit for doing what she did. But it would be an ideal throw-off if she were the mole.
Jim says he doesn't think Steve's the mole, but I think he's being played by Steve. I don't trust him at all.
Yeah, it could be the mole, sure. No doubt.
My hunch is Steve was potentially the mole at work. For some strange reason, he opted not to be painted nude, which I found very interesting for a guy that is never short of conversation when it comes to sex. And all of a sudden, he became acutely shy.
I suspect Jennifer had a little something to do with those socks myself. She put the onus on me, but in my mind, put it back on her.
Just practice some meditative breathing and I'll be okay, I think.
So far, there's $250,000 in the pot. You've all been playing the game very well. Tonight, you face your third execution. In a few moments, I'll be entering your names into this computer. If a green thumbprint appears after your name has been entered, you remain in the game. If a red thumbprint appears after your name has been entered, you are the mole's third victim. Kate, you earned an exemption in your last test. You will not face execution tonight. All right, let's begin. Good luck. Do I have any volunteers for first? Henry. Henry. Steven. Jim? Jim. Okay. Wendy. Wendy.
Definitely Miss Wendy. She was one of the quietest members of the group, but she will definitely be missed by this group.
She was really an important part of the group because she was always up for anything. That enthusiasm and dedication is going to be missed.
For the love of God, someone help me.
You know, she was down for whatever. She had just like that winning spirit. Anytime we got in a pinch, you knew you could count on her. She wouldn't let us down.
I'm definitely gonna miss Wendy. I'm gonna miss just having her like personality and spirit around, definitely.
Shucks.
Quite great.
Thank you.
We're gonna miss you a lot, Wendy.
Oh, thank you. Take care. Tell everybody I'm gonna miss them.
I will.
And have a good game.
All right.
Okay, bye.
Stay tuned for Scenes from the Mole.